ऑपरेटिंग रेशियो, ऑपरेटिंग रेशियो। चिल्ड्रन, दिस ऑपरेटिंग रेशियो इज वन ऑफ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट प्रॉफिटेबिलिटी रेशियो। ओके, हाउ टू कैलकुलेट दिस रेशियो? द फॉर्मूला ऑफ ऑपरेटिंग रेशियो इज कॉस्ट ऑफ गुड सोल्ड प्लस ऑपरेटिंग एक्सपेंसेस अपॉन रेवेन्यू फ्रॉम ऑपरेशन मल्टीप्लाई बाय 100। नाउ यू कैन सी दिस कॉस्ट ऑफ गुड सोल्ड प्लस ऑपरेटिंग एक्सपेंसेस इज ऑल्सो नोन एज ऑपरेटिंग कॉस्ट। ओके, सो टुगेदर इट इज नोन एज ऑपरेटिंग कॉस्ट। हाउ टू कैलकुलेट कॉस्ट ऑफ गुड सोल्ड? सो चिल्ड्रन, वी हैव फॉर्मूला टू कैलकुलेट कॉस्ट ऑफ गुड सोल्ड। Revenue from operation minus gross profit. This is one formula which we have to calculate COGS. And we have one more formula to calculate COGS. That is opening inventory plus purchase minus closing inventory. So these are the formulas which we can use in this ratio. So children, let us begin. All some numericals, है ना? Question number 124. Cost of revenue from operation means cost of goods sold is given 3 lakh. Question number 124. Cost of goods sold is given 3 lakh. Operating expenses are given 1,20,000. Operating expenses are given 1,20,000. Okay, revenue from operation means cash sales and return both are given. So cash sales is given 5,20,000. 5,20,000, and sales return is given 20,000. Sales return is given 20,000. So sales minus sales return is equal to revenue from operation or net sales. And revenue from operation is known as net sales. So we have calculated net sales. Net sales is 5 lakh, and cost of goods sold plus operating expenses is equal to operating cost. Operating cost will be 4,20,000. And so let's put in the formula. Operating ratio is equal operating cost divided by revenue from operation multiplied by 100. So let's see, operating ratio is equal to operating cost. We have computed 4,20,000, and revenue from operation we have computed 5 lakh multiplied by 100. So let us solve. When we solve, we get 84%. So operating ratio is 84%. I hope this question is clear to everyone. Operating ratio means operating cost divide by revenue from operation into 100. We have seen that cost of goods sold plus operating expenses is equal to operating cost, and operating cost is directly given in this question. Operating ratio will be operating cost is given 6 lakh, and revenue from operation is given 12 lakh multiply by 100, so it becomes 50%. Yes or no? Very simple. I hope it is clear. So let's continue with next question. Is it written by everyone?
Yes, sir.
बात. ओके
यस सर.
क्वेश्चन नंबर 126. क्वेश्चन नंबर 126. ऑपरेटिंग रेशियो इज गिवन 92%. ओके नाउ इन दिस क्वेश्चन ऑपरेटिंग रेशियो इज गिवन 92%. ऑपरेटिंग एक्सपेंसेस आर गिवन 94,000. ऑपरेटिंग एक्सपेंसेस आर गिवन 94,000. रेवेन्यू फ्रॉम ऑपरेशन इज गिवन 6 लाख. Revenue from operation is given 6 lakh. Sales return is given 40,000. Children, we do not use sales return here because revenue from operation means total sales minus sales return. When RFO is given, it means sales return is already deducted in sales. RFO means revenue from operation means net sales, and net sales means the sales in which sales return is already deducted. So we do not need sales return. Calculate cost of goods sold. Okay, so we need to calculate cost of goods sold in this question. Okay, so ready? Operating ratio is given, so first I will write the formula of operating ratio. So operating ratio means cost of goods sold plus operating expenses upon revenue from operation multiply by 100. This is the formula. So we can calculate cost of goods sold because everything is given in this question. Operating ratio is 92%, or we can write 92. This 100 can come here, 92 by 100. 92% means 92 by 100 is equal to cost of goods sold. It is not given, dear children. Plus operating expenses is given 94,000, yes or no? Divide by revenue from operation. Revenue from operation is given 6 lakh. So let us solve it. So 6 lakh multiplied by 92,000 and divide by 100. So let us solve in this manner. 6 lakh into 92 divided by 100 is equal to cost of goods sold plus 94,000. Okay, let us solve it. So it becomes 6,000 multiplied by 92. 6,000 multiplied by 92. 5,52,000 is equal to cost of goods sold plus 94,000. And then we solve one more step further. So we get cost of goods sold is equal to 5,52,000 minus 94,000. And cost of goods sold will be 5,52,000 minus 94,000 is equal to 4,58,000. So in this manner we have computed cost of goods sold, isn't it? So I hope this question is clear to everyone. Is it clear, dear children? Written by everyone?
Yes sir.
Okay, so let's move on next. Question number 127. Question number 127, under this two points are given, two questions are given. 127 first point, cost of revenue from operation means cost of goods sold is given 2,20,000. Okay, let us write cost of goods sold is given 2,20,000. Revenue from operation is given 3,20,000. Okay, selling expenses 12,000. Selling expenses selling expenses are given 12,000, office expenses 8,000, office expenses 8,000, depreciation 6,000, So selling expenses, office and depreciation, these three are operating expenses. Operating expenses are the expenses which are necessary to carry out regular activities of the business. Expenses which are incurred in the general and regular nature of the business. That is known as operating expenses, to generate operating activities and operating profit. 12 plus 8, 20, 20 plus 6, 26,000. All these expenses are necessary for doing business. Regular expenses, all these are regular expenses. So these are operating expenses. So your operating expenses are 26,000. We need to calculate operating ratio. And operating ratio means cost of goods sold plus operating expenses divided by revenue from operation into 100. So let's calculate operating ratio by putting all these values in the formula. Cost of goods sold is 2,20,000 plus operating expenses we have computed 26,000 divided by revenue from operation, that is 3,20,000, multiply by 100. So let us solve it. Operating ratio is equal to, let me solve, 2,46,000 divided by 3,20,000. 76.875 is, so we can round up 88%. Okay, I hope the question is clear to everyone. Written by everyone?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
So let's move on next. Question number 128.
Sir.
Yes.
Sir, it is having two parts.
Achha. Okay. So first, second. This is first part, na? So 127, second part. So let's begin question number 127, second part. 127, second part. Revenue from operation in this cash sales and credit sales are given. Okay. So cash sale and credit sale both are given. How much? It is given 4 lakh and 1 lakh. When we add these two, what we get? Total sales. Total sales, yes or no? Gross profit is given 1 lakh. Gross profit is given in this question 1 lakh. Office and selling expenses are given 50,000. Office and selling expenses are given 50,000. Calculate operating profit ratio. Okay. So to calculate operating profit ratio, operating ratio, what is needed? We need cost of goods sold plus operating expenses. Operating expenses are given in the question 50,000. This office and selling expenses are operating expenses, regular expenses of the business. अपॉन रेवेन्यू फ्रॉम ऑपरेशन दैट इज ऑल्सो गिवन टोटल सेल्स हियर है ना मल्टीप्लाई बाय 100. In this question, we need cost of goods sold, which is not given in the question. How can we calculate cost of goods sold? Cost of goods sold means revenue from operation. In this question, total sales will be revenue from operation. Revenue from operation minus gross profit. Okay, so we can calculate COGS. Cost of goods sold is equal to revenue from operation 5 lakh. Minus gross profit is 20, sorry, 1 lakh. Gross profit is given 1 lakh. So 5 lakh minus 1 lakh is equal to 4 lakh. So cost of goods sold is computed 4 lakh. Now we can put cost of goods sold in the formula of operating ratio. So cost of goods sold is 4 lakh plus operating expenses, office and selling expenses are given 50,000. 50,000 divided by revenue from operation. Revenue from operation means here total sales is given. And sales return is not given. Otherwise, we subtract sales return and then we get net sales. But here sales return is not given. So that total sales will be considered as RFO. It is given 5 lakh. So 5 lakh multiply by 100. So let us solve it. 4,50,000. 4,50,000. Divide by 5 lakh, multiply by 100 is equal to 90%. Yes or no, dear children? I hope it is clear. It's clear to everyone. Let's move on next. Question number 128. Question number 128. From the following information, calculate operating ratio. So we need to calculate operating ratio. Cost of goods sold is given here 52,000. Operating expenses are given. Gross sales is given. And sales return is given. So almost all things are given directly in this question. So we can simply calculate operating ratio. Cost of goods sold plus operating expenses upon revenue from operation multiply by 100. So operating ratio is equal to cost of goods sold is given 52,000 plus operating expenses are given 18,000. Divide by revenue from operation. Gross sales is given and we need net sales. Hai na? So gross sales minus sales return means 88 minus 8. 88 minus 8, 80,000. So RFO will be 80,000. Multiply by 100. So 50, 60, 70. 70,000 divide by 80,000. Multiply by 100. 1 by 8 is equal to 12.5. 12.5 into 7. 87.5. So operating ratio is 87.5. I hope it is clear to everyone. Clear? Hai?
Yes, sir.
Okay, let's move on next. Next question. Question number 129. Question number 129. Calculate cost of revenue from operation from the following information. Revenue from operation is given 12 lakh. Okay. revenue from operation is given 12 lakh. Operating ratio is given 75%. Operating ratio is given 75%. Operating expenses 1 lakh. Operating expenses 1 lakh. We need to calculate cost of revenue from operation, means COGS. Can we calculate? Yes, we can calculate very easily, because operating expenses are given. So we can calculate operating cost. We know that operating ratio is equal to operating cost multiply by 100 divided by RFO. Yes or no? So we can calculate operating cost by using this formula. Operating ratio is given 75. So 75%, so this 100 can come here. We can directly write 75 by 100 is equal to operating cost divided by RFO. RFO is given 12 lakh. Now simply by cross multiplication we can calculate operating cost. Yes or no? So operating cost will be 12 lakh multiply by 75 divide by 100. So let's calculate 12,000 multiply by 75. So it would be 9 lakh. So operating cost is 9 lakh. And we know the formula of operating cost also. Operating cost means cost of goods sold plus operating expenses. So by using this formula we can calculate cost of goods sold. Operating cost we have computed 9 lakh. Cost of goods sold we do not know, we need to calculate. And operating expenses in this question are given 1 lakh. So COGS is equal to cost of goods sold is equal to 9 lakh minus 1 lakh is equal to 8 lakh. Hai na? I hope it is clear to everyone. Yes, dear children. So let us move on next.
Yes.
Let us move on next. Question number 130. Question number 130. Calculate operating ratio from the following information. We need to calculate operating ratio. Operating cost is given 6,80,000. Gross profit is given 25%. Operating expenses given 80,000. We need to calculate operating profit ratio with these information. So children, revenue from operation is not given. We need to calculate revenue from operation. To calculate revenue from operation, first we need cost of goods sold. Hai na? So let's calculate first point, cost of goods sold. And we know that cost of goods sold is equal to operating cost minus operating expenses. Operating cost minus operating expenses. So COGS, cost of goods sold, will be 6,80,000 minus 80,000. So COGS will be 6 lakh. Is that clear? Now cost of goods sold is computed. Now we know that RFO is not given, but gross profit is given. So to calculate RFO, let us prepare one more working note. Suppose revenue, we know that revenue from operation minus gross profit is equal to COGS. Say yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
And RFO is not given, so we assume that RFO is X, revenue from operation is X. Okay. Minus gross profit. If RFO is X, gross profit is 25%. 25% means 25 upon 100. 25 upon 100 means 1 by 4. It means gross profit is X by 4, yes or no? Is equal to cost of goods sold, and cost of goods sold we have computed rupees 6 lakh. Isn't it? So let's calculate this equation to calculate RFO. X minus X by 4 is equal to 3X by 4 by taking an LCM is equal to 6 lakh. And when we cross multiply, we get X, hai na? So 6 lakh multiply by 4 divide by 3, and X is equal to 3, 2 ja 6, 2, 4 ja 8. X means your revenue from operation. Now your revenue from operation is 8 lakh. Now you can easily compute operating profit ratio, operating ratio. So your operating ratio will be, operating cost is given in the question, 6,80,000, divide by RFO we have computed 8 lakh, multiply by 100. So let's calculate, 6,80,000 divided by 8 lakh. 85%. So I hope this question is clear to everyone.